Aspen is getting behind clean energy, and Breck ski maker RMU wins an award for mountain bike gear. Phil Lindemann with Krystal, 93 News. First, authorities have charged a 22-year-old with first-degree murder in the shooting death of an Adams County sheriff's deputy. The Associated Press reports that Drayon Deering is charged with first-degree murder and burglary for shooting and killing Deputy Heath Gum on January 24th. Gum was 31 years old. Law enforcement's holding a public ceremony for Gum tomorrow, Friday, and two Summit County sheriff's deputies are part of the honor guard for the funeral. No word on two other suspects who fled the scene. Breckenridge's local ski maker, Rocky Mountain Underground, is getting into the mountain bike gear business, and they're winning awards already. This from the Summit Daily. RMU's new tailgate bike carrier won Best of the Show with Gear Junkie at the Outdoor Retailer Expo in Denver last week. It's like other padded tailgate carriers from Troy Lee Designs and Dekine, but RMU's has more straps and pockets, apparently. It fits five bikes and goes on sale this summer for $280. Towns like Breckenridge and Pueblo are partnering with Xcel Energy to bring 100% renewable energy to Colorado by 2040, and the Aspen Times reports Aspen Skiing Company is throwing its hat in the ring. Aspen and Alterra Mountain Company are backing a proposal to replace aging coal plants in Pueblo with wind and solar energy. If the proposal passes, it could tip Colorado's energy scales from 30% renewable to 55% renewable. Dollar General is making big money off America's poorest residents. The Economist reports that the national dollar store chain now has 14,000 locations. That's as many as McDonald's, and most are in the poorest communities. Dollar General is worth $28 billion, though, nearly double Macy's and other stores that are struggling to stay open. And the chain is thriving on location. Most stores are in neighborhoods where residents earn less than $29,000 per year, and where Walmart is nowhere to be found. Olympic goalkeeper Hope Solo says the U.S. Soccer Federation is playing for the men and not the women. This from the Associated Press. Solo filed a complaint against the federation this week, saying it gives more money and attention to Major League Soccer than girls' programs or the U.S. women's national team. Solo filed her complaint with the U.S. Olympic Committee. She is one of eight candidates currently running for president of the Soccer Federation. She won Olympic gold with the U.S. women's national team in 2008 and 2012, and she's also a 2015 World Cup champion. For context, the U.S. men's national team recently failed to qualify, period, for the World Cup for the first time since 1980. In sports, the Nuggets play the Thunder tonight. That's on TNT at 8:30, and the Colorado Avalanche play the Edmonton Oilers at 7. In local sports, brought to you by Dillon Ridge Liquors, the Summit High girls basketball team plays Buena Vista at home today. And in junior hockey news, the Breckenridge Bolts are back in Breck this weekend for a three-game series against the league-best Steamboat Wranglers. First game is Friday, and cost all weekend is $5 per game. Phil Lindemann with Krystal, 93 News.